Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. Landry gets the outside again.
Lovely on the carry. Not-
breaks through and he's into the end zone. He is dropped in the backfield by Kieran Freeman. First handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races. Touchdown! No Wanter just plowed through three or four tacklers. Frontier Red Hawk football.
Starting lineup for your Frontier Red Hawks, coached by Mr. Don Gordon. The center is number 55, Jonathan Delaney. The guards are 73, Kate Galanta, and 79, Matt Carlson. Tackles are 63, Joel Hildreth, and number 66, Luke Parsons. The tight end is number 15, Cole Price. Wide receiver, 42, Joe Morawski. The fullback is 45, Seth Galanter. Halfbacks are number 28, Aaron Landry, and number 29, Stephen Worthley.
Taking a snap, Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. It's football night in South Deerfield tonight. The unbeaten Turner's Falls Indians coming to take on the Red Hawks in a battle for postseason superiority and possibly the Red Hawks to share the Intercounty League North Championship. Hi again, I'm Chris Collins, along with Emilio Didonna, Kevin Murphy, Zach Pelk, and Alec Eckler here on working the cameras. And Emilio, this is the game of the year in the Intercounty League for sure. You know, I'm not sure what if the schedulers, when they were drawing the schedule up for the year, knew in advance these two teams are going to be locking horns on the last game of the regular season, but this is going to be a big one tonight.
Yeah, this is for playoff contention. As of last game, Aaron Landry, for the first time in Frontier history, broke 1,000 yards rushing, and it's going to be a good game.
We'll talk about Aaron Landry and the running games. Both these teams have strong running attacks, but as I mentioned, the Indians 7-0 overall, 4-0 in the Intercounty League North. They've already claimed at least a share of their fourth consecutive division title. Frontier's 5-1, 3-1, looking to grab a slice of the IL North title for itself, and a win by the Red Hawks would make it a three-way tie for the top spot in the league along with Athol. Now, surprisingly enough, even if the Red Hawks win tonight, there's no guarantee that they're going to clinch a playoff spot because some other things have to happen. A couple of Berkshire teams have to lose. Ware has to lose. So Frontier can control its destiny to a certain point with a win today, but they can't guarantee themselves a postseason berth.
Yep, and that's not specifically good for them, but they could survive even with the win. And in a way, they do control their own destiny.
Both teams have shown the ability to put points on the board for sure. Frontier comes in having scored 166 points in four league games this year, while the Indians are second in the IL with 141 points scored in four games. No other team has even come close to breaking 100. So some real high-powered offense here, absolutely. But defensively, this is where it gets interesting because Turner's comes in having held league opponents to the fewest points this season with 26 allowed in four games. Frontier is third with 56 points allowed. So both defenses have gotten the job done. But here's the thing. I don't think Turner's has come up against a running attack as powerful as the Frontier Redhawks between Landry, Worthley, and Gawanter. And Miles Freeman back there, one of the more accurate quarterbacks in the league. A lot of weapons back there. I don't think Turner's has seen a offense this quite this high power.
No, it's very versatile, too. Good passing game, running game, power game, and really all-around versatile team.
It does come down, I think, in a lot of ways to defense, and Frontier's run defense is strong. Where Frontier is suspect defensively somewhat is in the secondary. Secondary hasn't been tested very much, and they're going up against Teon Brown, who's 17 for 36 passing for 374 yards this season. Teon can throw the ball, and that could cause problems for the Redhawks.
Yep, the pressure could get there to the quarterback, but they got to make it get there, because without that, they have nothing.
Turner's falls. The Frontier's defense has proven it can stop the run or at least contain the run, but they're going to have to contain Quinn Doyle, who failed to top the 100-yard mark for the first time all season last weekend. but leads all area backs with 1,171 yards on the season. Jack Darling entered the week with 170 yards in the season. He added 189 yards in last week's game. And Ricky Craver is the other guy in the backfield who is to look out for. Frontier, of course, counting with the 300 monster of Landry, Wordley, and Gowanter. And you mentioned, Emilio, Landry had his biggest performance of the season last week. 8 carries, 243 to break the 1,000-yard mark. He comes in with 1,039 yards. Upcoming, the Redhawks and the Indians. Football night in South Deerfield on Frontier Community Access Television. Welcome back to South Deerfield. Upcoming, the Frontier Redhawks and the unbeaten Turner's Falls Indians. On senior night, congratulations to our seniors, Miles Freeman, Alperin Yidlis, Dalton DeForest, Joe Morosky, Cade Gowanter, Seth Gowanter, J.B. Delaney, Luke Parsons, and Ryan Olmsted playing their final home games as members of this team. Hopefully it's not going to be their last game. Although, if they don't make the playoffs, the Redhawks will play other games in the next couple of weeks, as one of the things about this new playoff format is the teams that make the playoffs play their playoff games, then in the next couple of weeks, the teams that don't make it will play other opponents they wouldn't ordinarily have played. So, kind of a nice wrinkle, gives a couple of extra weeks of football, but these Redhawks would love to be in the Division IV playoff hunt. As the captains come to the center of the field for the coin toss, I think first possession is pretty important in this game, Emilio, because both these teams have explosive offenses and they would love to be the first ones to put some points on the board and put the other guys into an early deficit.
Yes, and it also is because this game is mainly about defense. So locking down your opponent on your first drive will be a big upset for the defense.
Absolutely, and that sends a message, too, especially if Turner's is able to shut down and vice versa. I mean, both these teams have explosive running attacks. They have pretty good passing attacks. So I'll be curious to see what Chris LaPointe and Don Gordon come out with for offensive sets to start this game. Turner's will get the ball first, so Frontier's defense will get a chance to prove themselves early on the first possession. And there have been a couple of times in the season where both of these teams have broken it in the first kickoff. So upcoming we'll have the Frontier Regional Marching Band with the National Anthem, and we'll get underway here. And what is being billed as the game of the year in the Intercounty League.
Please rise, remove their hats as the Frontier Regional Band honors America by playing our national anthem.
Okay, the hype is over, the talking is done, and now it's time to play some football where it counts on the field. Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna, our crew here at South Deerfield tonight, Kevin Murphy, Zach Pelk, and Alec Eckel running the cameras Kevin and I were talking about the football schedule, Emilio. We knew this one was going to be big. We had this one circled on the calendar with good reason.
Yep, it's the game that decides their, well, might as well decide their playoff hopes.
Back deep, Ricky Craver for the Indians and Nick Croteau, both seniors.
Kicking off for the Redhawks, number 30, Corbin Blight. Back for the Indians,
Corbin Blight.
Five, Ricky Craver.
We'll kick it off. Corbin Blight, in a couple of games this season, had a tendency to kick toward the sidelines. They racked him up a bunch of penalties against Franklin Tech. We'll see what he does here, as these are two explosive deep men for Turner's Falls. Blight checks both sides. We're ready to rock from South Deerfield. Straight ahead kick, taken at about the 19-yard line by Craver. Craver gets back up to about the 37-yard line. It's good for about a 16-yard return.
Indians, first and 10 from the Turner's Falls 33-yard line.
The ball spotted at the 33 of Turner's. Teon Brown, it's Quinn Doyle back there. In motion now goes Crota. Handoff goes up the middle.
Quinn Doyle and a carry.
Quinn Doyle, you're going to hear that name a lot tonight. He gets up to about the 36-yard line, a gain of about three.
Red Hawks, gain of three, second and seven.
Nothing fancy, just straight up off tackle.
That's what both teams like to do. That's what they usually do.
Now a double wing formation. Doyle goes in motion. Inside Gibb goes to the fullback. He gets probably two or three more yards. That was Jack Darling with the carry.
Good gang tackling there.
Luke Parsons had to stop for
Frontier. Right there. Tried to fool him. Didn't work.
Maybe two on that one. That'll bring up third and five from the 38 of Turner's. I expect to see a lot of running, but I wouldn't be surprised to see Teon Cork run off there. He has double wideouts on the far side. Inside give goes to Doyle. Delayed handoff. First down yardage and more. He is up to about midfield or close to it. Good run by Quinn.
Miles Freeman on
great,
the stop for the
great end blocks there on the outside.
First and 10, Turner's.
It's
going to
be a first down for Turner's at the 47-yard line. So they're moving the ball nicely here. That's good for a gain of nine by Quinn Doyle. Nothing fancy. And, of course, this Frontier defensive line, very, very strong, and they'll test it early.
That's usually their strength.
And the pitch goes to Doyle again as they spread the field a little bit. Gets up to about midfield. It's a gain of about three.
Stephen Worthley on the stop.
Bring up second and seven. No, actually second and eight. Second and six, rather, because he just got past midfield.
Looks like they're going to be running a lot today.
Yeah, this is, you know,
second
as advertised, you know, this is what they do. But they'll throw it, too, if they think they have an opportunity. Right now they've got four wideouts. And in motion goes Jack Darling. And Darling gets the handoff around the end. Darling's got the corner. Good speed out of bounds. And that's going to be good for a good first down yardage for the Indians. Running the ball very well right now.
Yes, definitely. That was a great block by the wide receiver. Got him an extra 10, 12 yards.
Turner's Falls from the Frontier 30-yard line.
That's good for 19 for Jack Darling, who's been on a mad tear recently. Ball spotted just outside the 30 of Frontier as the Indians are in business. I formation behind Teon Brown again. Gives it to the big man,
Doyle
up the middle. He gets a couple of yards, maybe
Tate
one,
on
to about the 29-yard line.
Into the yard, second and nine.
So far, they've only run runs this game. Let's see if they have any passes on this whole drive.
Yeah, I mean, if it's working. And Doyle again, off right tackle. He gets a big hole. He's got first down yardage and more inside
Doyle
Frontier's red zone. See where they spot it, but another big run for Quinn Doyle.
Big hole, he saw it, he hit it. Got about 10, 15 yards.
This ball spotted inside the 20 at about the 18.
This is 10 Indians from the Redhawks 17-yard line.
And we'll call it the 17. That's good for 12 for Doyle. And now this goes to Darling, left side. And he is inside the 15 to about the 13-yard line.
This run game is just grinding on him. Pounding it up the middle, pounding it outside. And anywhere they can get it, they'll do it.
Yeah, and this is pretty much surgical. And again, I don't think that Frontier has seen an offense quite as refined as this one. I mean, these guys, there's a reason they're 7-0. Tion under center. And the handoff goes to Doyle, right tackle.
Doyle on a carry.
And he's up to about the 10-yard line as they continue to roll the ball. Let's see if they got first down here.
Nope. Third in the yard for Turners.
Gonna get third one
from the Hawk 15-yard line.
About the 15-yard line or something.
Way to defend the sticks there, stopping about inches short from the first down.
So third one from the 10 as pretty much all pluses in the run column for Turners. Inside give goes to Jack Darling again, and that's going to be good for a first down. And it's first and goal.
First and goal for the Indians.
And just outside the 5 at about the 6-yard line.
From the Redhawks 6-yard line.
Well, if they show them any, I think the Redhawks are going to be going all out for the run on the series.
Well, they've run it all the way, and they have pretty much marched down the field unstopped. And it's going to be a flag.
Flags on the play.
We'll see what they call here, who they get. It looks like it's going to be on, it might be on Turner's. Or is it on, Frontier?
On the Redhawks.
It's on Frontier.
That was a devastating penalty, bringing him down to the 1-yard line.
Well, no, actually, he's half the distance, so then ball will be spotted at the 3. But you're right. Still sets up a first and goal from the 3.
That's never a good sign.
That's never a good, thing, ever. First and goal from the 3.
Unless you're Turner's.
Well, yeah. If you're a Turner's Fall Indians fan, you're thrilled right now. Brown under center. Quick two-step pass, incomplete.
That would have been an easy touchdown if he just hold that in, but nope. Hit him in the hands, went incomplete.
Well, you were wondering if they were going to go for the pass, and that would have been a great way. Frontier was totally crossed up on it, but unfortunately for Turner's, Craver could not quite handle it.
Those are the balls you got to hang on to.
Second and 3. Second and goal, actually, from the 3. As the lone back is Quinn Doyle. And it's going to go to Doyle off Quinn right Doyle tackle. And is he in? He is close.
Short.
Got to about the 1, it looks like.
From the 1-yard line.
Good run, but better stop. Stopping him short of the goal line.
Well, Frontier has an opportunity here if they can do a goal line stand. Be a huge morale booster if they could stop Turner's here, but they haven't stopped them yet on this first drive.
Third and goal from the 1.
Tion under center. And it's going to go to Doyle again. He busts Doyle over left tackle, and is he in? I don't know if he got in. Nope.
Fourth and goal.
He got about a half a yard, or not even a half a yard.
What a stop. Doyle jumping over the pile, but it's still short.
He got 1. Fourth and goal from the 1. Wow.
This could be a momentum changer here.
It absolutely could.
Timeout called by Turner's Falls.
So Chris LaPointe will take a quick timeout to talk it over.
Frontier Parents selling 50-50 raffle tickets.
So, Emilio, as we expected, this is a... I don't think we expected Turner's to move the ball quite as easily as they have against this Frontier defense, but give them credit where it's due. They have pretty much controlled the line of scrimmage, and that's what you have to do.
Yeah, they've had incredible blocking throughout the whole drive, especially wide receiver blocking.
And they've taken almost 6 minutes off this first quarter clock with this drive, which is also significant.
Some people say time of possession doesn't matter, but it looks like it's going to matter a fair amount in this game.
It very well might. And this is one of those games which could be decided by one touchdown. You never know. I mean, Turner's has already played one of those games this year with Greenfield. They beat Greenfield by a lone touchdown. But they can score in bunches. Last week against Dapple, they scored a bunch of fourth quarter points to make that win stand up.
Inside the 1 yard line.
What happens this time?
So goal line stand time. Can the Hawks keep the Indians out of the end zone? Fourth and goal from inside the one. Sanders, full house backfield. And it's going to go to Doyle. Doyle over right tackle. Easy peasy. Touchdown. 6-0 Indians.
Good block by the offensive line there. There's one man there. Couldn't bring him down. That's an easy.
Well, that was an impressive drive. Chewed up almost 6 minutes. Ends with a Quinn Doyle 1 yard touchdown run.
If they can do that all game, that'll be very good for them.
Yeah. 2-point conversion attempt upcoming. You know, Frontier has not been consistent on 2-point conversion attempts on offense, but Turner's has been pretty good, pretty solid in that regard. Brown under center again, and he's going to roll out. Brown passing for 2 points.
And Brown's pass.
And the pass is complete.
Five, for the 2 points.
So we'll come back up the field as the Indians draw first blood. 5:07 to go in the first quarter. On the scoreboard, it's Turner's 8. Frontier nothing. This is Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. So, Frontier Red Hawks are in a quick 8-0 hole, courtesy of a very, very good 67-yard drive. It took up about 6 minutes of that first quarter clock. Tam Brown to kick it. Back deep. Landry, Worthley. And Tion, a straight head-to-head kick. They're going to let it roll all the way back. And it'll be taken at about the 7-yard line by Miles Freeman. Brings it back up.
He's
knocked back down at the 26-yard line, but there is a flag down behind the play.
That might have hit him on the foot, too. That was a risky decision to let it go past him.
Yes, it was.
Let's see what the flag is.
Let's see what we got here. That was good for about a 17-yard return by Miles Freeman.
Chop block, Red Hawks.
Chop block on Frontier, not good. So that's going to knock them back, I think, about 10 yards.
Definitely not good. After already being down 8-0, a penalty gives them bad starting field position. Not great momentum to start off.
That's a 15-er, I think. 15-yard penalty, so not
first
the way you want to start.
Red Hawks. From the Frontier 11-yard line.
So starting off at the 11 for the Hawks. Under center for Frontier is Yidlis. And up the middle,
Gawanter on the carry.
Seth Gawanter with the carry. And pick up of about 3 yards on that one.
Pretty decent pile pushing. Could have ended up with a second and six.
Second and seven from the 14. Clock is in motion. Handoff. Off right tackle. That's Steve Worthley with the carry.
Will Rivera's got a stop for the Indians.
And
a yard, third and five.
I'd say they gave him probably 2 on that one. Third and 5 from the 16. Inside draw again.
Steve Worthley
and
on
that's
the carry.
Worthley yet again with the run. And that's good for first down.
Quinn
so.
Doyle on the stop.
2 runs, just over 10 yards.
Very good
start
for a Red Hawk first down.
Ball spotted at the 22, it looks like, or actually the 19. Another run up the middle.
Worthley on a carry.
And that's Steve again. So Worthley, Landry has not touched the ball quite yet in this game.
Gain of 4, second and 6 for the Hawks.
It's a gain of 4, second and 6 upcoming.
Well, if they don't need to put him in, they might not, but, you know, probably better for the team overall if they do.
And inside handoff again. You got that one. That's Gawanter.
Ryland Castine on a stop. Third in a long three for the Hawks. From the Red Hawk 29-yard line.
Pitch goes to Landry, and he has stood up.
Landry on a carry.
And not really going anywhere on that one.
Turner's just dominating Frontier at the line on offense and defense.
Gain of maybe a yard. It'll be fourth and three for the Red Hawks.
Interesting.
Worley back to punt for the
Worley's going to punt. This is rare. You don't often see Frontier punting. High snap. Worley handles it. And a very short punt. Wow. That may have only been like 5 yards. So Turner's is going to have great field position.
Frontier 33-yard line. Indians take over first and 10.
That is not anything you want to give the Indians, that kind of field position for sure.
No, that's going to affect their decisions to punt for the rest of the game.
Ball spotted at the 34-yard line of Frontier. So Tion Brown has a short field to play with here. And a chance to go up by two scores. 2:15 to go in the first quarter. Doyle goes in motion. Pitch goes to Quinn. Off right tackle. Quinn blasts ahead close to first down yardage.
Miles Freeman on a stop.
Let's see what they get. Where they spot it.
Gain of five, second and five for the Indians.
Ball spotted at the 29-yard line. Well, if you're a Red Hawk fan, you got to be concerned about this. This is, I haven't seen many three and outs for Frontier this year. Side draw goes to Darling again, and Jack's got a first down. And he is so explosive out of the backfield.
That play, they all pursued it on Doyle. And then
carry good for an Indian first
down. Went through
that
hole. Everybody was at Doyle. Decent game.
Ball is spotted.
First and 10 Turners from the Frontier 22-yard line.
22, so that was good for 7. And this goes to Doyle again. Doyle cuts back up the middle, flag behind the play. Might be coming back, could be a hold. Let's see what they call. Yep, holding on offense.
A 10-yard penalty. Remain first down.
So that's going to be a first and 20 from the
first and 20 for the Indians.
32, and that's the first penalty on Turner's Falls. Ball spotted at the 32-yard line again. 1:17 to go in the first quarter. 8-0 Turners. They have the ball. Darling in motion. Gets the handoff around right end. Cuts back away. Darling, good pursuit by Frontier.
Great.
That's the first
tackle.
Loss, I think.
What a tackle.
That was a good tackle.
And Freeman.
Frontier read that perfectly.
Saw it come and hit it instantly. They've been doing it all game. Frontier finally
loss
found an
yard.
Answer.
Second and 21.
Second and 21 from the 33. So that's the first negative yardage tonight of the Turner's Falls Indians. Great read by the ends of Frontier. Double wideouts to the near side, I formation behind Tion Brown. Pitch goes to Doyle as they spread it out again. Doyle cuts around left end, gets the corner, and it's knocked out of bounds.
And
around the 15-yard line. So that's going to be a close to a first down. We'll see.
That is not what Frontier wants. They've been stopped. They stopped them twice. Well, counting the holding penalty. And then Doyle, again, just managed to get around that edge. And once he gets around that edge, he has room. That secondary is not there to get him down.
So that's going to bring up a third and 5 from the 13 of Frontier. Tion keeps it, quick pass. incomplete.
Pass is incomplete.
That would have been a big play for them. First down in the red zone, but nope, fourth and five coming up.
So this is decision time here.
And for number 15, Nick Proto, Indians, fourth and five.
So drive, they only gained about 8 yards and are already in the red zone. That is not a good punt.
20.3 seconds left. They're going to go for it. They're going to go for a field goal here. No, they're going to go from the shotgun. Teon's going to throw on fourth and five. Brown fires it downfield. Complete. And
pass
in
complete to number five,
for the touchdown.
Ricky
it looks
Craver
like Ricky Craver.
Indian touchdown.
Wow.
He was wide open. Faked in. The defender completely got baited by that. Cut it right out. Easy touchdown.
A 13-yard touchdown pass. Craver from Teon Brown. And with 13 seconds left, the Indians go up by two touchdowns.
The corner over pursued there. That was that whole touchdown. There would have been nothing there if he had just followed that route.
And except for the two-point conversion. And Brown rolls out, fires it over the end zone, over the middle rather. Pass incomplete. And the two-point conversion fails. We'll come back up the field with 13 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Turner's Falls 14, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna, and Kevin Murphy. Also here along with Zach Pelk and Alec Eckel. And right now, Turner's Falls Indians in the driver's seat. They have scored two times to take a 14-0 lead. Teon Brown to kick it off. Miles Freeman back deep along with Wordley and Landry. Quick end-over-end kick, and Landry will take it at about the 25. Jukes his way upfield and is brought down at about the 42-yard line. So a decent return, about 17 yards, which is where the Red Hawks will take over.
About 35 yards better field position than their last drive, which is definitely good for them.
7.8 seconds to go in the quarter. We might have time to get one playoff here. Ball is spotted at the 40 of Frontier. Freeman under center. And quick cross buck handoff up the middle. Whoa, and it got leveled. Did Steve Wordley, or excuse me, and he gets up to about the 47. And that is how the first quarter will end. So we're going to change ends, come back with second quarter action at the end of one quarter. It's Turner's Falls 14 and Frontier nothing. This is Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins and Emilio Didonna back here. Second quarter action upcoming. So this is something unusual, Emilio. I'm doing this quick stat sheet here. 16 yards total offense for Frontier after one quarter. You know, that's pretty amazing when you consider that they've pretty much had their way with many of the teams they've played this year.
Turner's Falls have just been dominating them at the line of scrimmage.
That's exactly why this is going the way it is. And Frontier's in a game now. They better realize it.
You have nothing at the line of scrimmage. You have nothing anywhere else.
Second and two from the 48. Miles Freeman rolling out. Quick pass over the middle to intended for Cole
Freeman's
Price. Incomplete.
Cole Price is
that'll bring up third and two. Cole Price, excuse
third
me.
And two
that
would have
been
Hawks.
A big play if he hung on to that. Two defenders down on the field. He had a lot of room.
Well, he likes Cole Price. I mean, Miles Freeman and Cole Price have hooked up quite a bit this year from the air. So big third and two here, the 48. And the Hawks have some work to do. Freeman under center. And the pitch goes left side to Landry. Landry able to break a tackle and get into Turner's Falls territory to about the 47. And that should be good for a first down.
He went for the hard hit there, but when you go all out for the hit, you might not get the tackle. And that's what happened right there.
That's the first yardage for in this game for Landry. He's only run one at a time and for no yardage. Full house backfield again. Inside give goes to Worthing. He gets absolutely stuffed. He may have lost a yard there.
Kyle Bergman on a stop.
Probably the worst game Frontier's line has been playing all season.
Well, we have not seen them get dominated
no
like this
play, second and 10.
On the line. And that's where this game is going to be won. And right now, Turner's is winning.
If they can recover, they can easily win this game.
Second and 10. Inside handoff again, little cross buck handoff. Gets it up to about the 41-yard line.
Quinn Doyle on a stop for the Indians.
It's a gain of about 6 yards.
Gain of about 6, third and 4 for the Hawks.
So Frontier is moving the ball, but in small chunks. Third and 4 for the Hawks. Wordly in motion. Now Miles rolls out. Fires it downfield, goes deep, way too deep though. Way too ahead of Price.
He had a step on the defender. But
not that many steps to catch that ball though.
No, not that many. If Freeman was getting pressured, had to throw it as quick as he could.
You know, decision time here, I think maybe you go for it. You're inside territory. I suppose you could punt it and pin them back inside their own 10 if possible, but Frontier's going to go for it here.
After last punt, they don't want to see that again.
Freeman rolling out again. Passes. And the pass is complete.
That was a nice throw by Freeman. Rolling out, hitting them low.
Well, was it enough for the first down? I don't know.
Spotting the ball.
Time out for a measurement.
They're going to have to measure this. He was really close to the stick. But I'm not sure he got there because he went down as he went down to catch the ball. So he's automatically down at that point. This is going to be a big measurement.
If he rolled over, he would have easily got it.
If he stayed on his feet.
First down.
Yep, first down.
Football's a game of inches. No.
That time it absolutely was. You're absolutely right.
Landry for a Red Hawk first down.
So we'll give him a gain of 3 on that pass. And that brings up first and 10 from the 38. And handoff inside.
Worthy
again. Worthy's been the workhorse tonight. He's gotten most of the touches. And he got inside the 35, it looks like, to about the 34.
They're trying to run their usual game plan here,
second and
but it's
seven.
Really not working. From finally starting to get something, but they might have to change it up a little.
A handoff to Landry, and I think he's got first down yardage.
To Wardley on a carry.
Some nice carry.
For a Red Hawk
right at
first
the middle.
Down.
Dive.
So first and 10 Red Hawks. As they seem to have shaken the cobwebs a little bit. And the ball is spotted at the 28. Freeman to pass. The pass is complete to Price. Price beats one defender and knocked out of bounds. So Cole Price in business.
Great run after that
catch.
Freeman threw it on the run. Nice catch, get out, but hold it in.
First and goal, Frontier.
Ran for a good 15 more yards after.
First and goal from the 10.
9-yard line.
Look at the 9. Hand off inside.
Hunter on the carry. Tackled by a host of Indians.
Great pile pushing on that play. Getting an extra 2 or 3 yards.
Yep. Second and goal from the 6.
there's any time to use Landry, it's now.
Inside give.
Landry on
and
the carry.
And there's Landry. You called it, Emilio. And yep. That gets him inside the five to about the four, so that's a gain of two. Third and goal from the four.
And LeBerge on the stop. Third and goal for the Redhawks.
Well, like you mentioned before, I mean, a stop here would be a big boost for the Turner's Falls Indians if they can do a little goal line stand action here. They're making Frontier earn every single yard they get. Inside give again. Pyle pushes ahead. Gawanter up to about the two, it looks like.
They need to think of something new here. That just Pyle pushing up the middle. Just gaining them yards, but not the yards they need.
Fourth and goal from the two. Timeout Frontier. As they want to talk it over. There's under 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. They trail 14-0. And this would be a big score for Frontier, getting back in the game. A bigger stop, though, for Turner's if they're able to get it. Once again, this game, very, very important for both teams. Obviously, Turner's Falls
again,
has already clinched a share of the league championship. They can win it outright with a win today. A Frontier win would keep them in the playoff hunt. But a loss here would pretty much eliminate their chances, so Frontier's got to win this game to be able to have a shot at going to the postseason.
And so far, this game has been lost in the trenches. But if they can win that, they can still come back and take a victory here.
Absolutely. And I think, we said it was going to be a battle on the line. It was going to be a defensive battle. Who had the best? Both teams have great offenses. Who had the better defense is going to decide this game, and that seems to be what's happening right now.
Turner's just showing it. Let's see if they can show it here.
Fourth and goal from the two. Gawanter is back in the backfield, and the big man's going to get it. They're going to spread it left side. Gawanter blasts over. Left tackle, left wing, touchdown.
What a way to dive over the defender.
Normally, that's just a power move up the middle, but they took an outside smart move, and he just ran over the end.
Diving over Nick Coquet.
14-6. That was just what the doctor ordered for the Frontier Redhawks. Big, big two-point conversion upcoming here. And this is, like I said, they've been inconsistent with the two-point conversion this season. This time it goes to Gawanter. Bounces off tackle. Did he get in?
Still going.
Still going. And he did not make it in. They just kept him out of the end zone.
Wow, he stayed up for a long time there. Getting hit by a lot of people, but they brought him down. He was still short.
That could end up being costly later on. We'll come back up the field. 6:50 to go, second quarter. On the scoreboard, it's the Turner's Falls Indians 14, the Frontier Redhawks 6. This is Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television.
Timeout for an injured player.
Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna back here at Frontier Regional School. Seth Gawanter has been taken off on a stretcher after being injured in the point after touchdown run. It looked like, from our angle, Emilio, he was trying to extend for a last half a yard to get into the end zone. It looks as though he must have sustained some kind of a lower leg injury. Very classy moment. Both the teams went out there to wish him well, side by side. So Seth Gawanter will not be returning to this game, so the Frontier Redhawks lose one of their leaders, and who knows, this might light a fire under the rest of the club, but you hate to see a kid like that be injured on senior night, especially in the biggest game of the year.
Oh yeah, definitely. His brother was really upset, so nothing good happened
on that one. Gawanter did score a touchdown run of 2 yards.
Take a moment to acknowledge the sportsmanship by both teams during that injury.
Absolutely. All right, time to kick off. Blight to kick it off for Frontier. End over end kick. It gets tipped on the way through and is picked up at about the 15-yard line. And rookie Craver is brought down after about a 4-yard return. Boy, that was quite a swarm by the Redhawks.
Yeah, he decided not to try to get it, and it went on the ground.
From the Indian 21-yard line.
Redhawks had a lot of time to get there.
First and 10 from the 21, 6:44 to go in the second quarter. Frontier trailing 14-6. And we'll see what the Turner Falls Indians bring in for an offense. They've got two backs. Now in motion goes Craver. And Tion's going to roll out on first down. Actually, the handoff goes to Craver. Nice fake. Cuts back up. He's got first down yardage and more. And Craver's brought down at about the 40-yard line. That's a quite a nice fake by Tion Brown there. And Griffey Craver, a good run.
Frontier looks angry. They were trying to hit him as hard as they could, but they just kept missing.
Yeah, and like we said before, okay, it looks like the initial analysis is a broken ankle for Seth Gowanter, so his season's probably over.
Doyle
with the carry up the right side, and he gets about 3 yards up to about the 43. Second and eight. And the 42 of Turner's Falls. Looks like the Frontier Redhawks are playing with a little bit more emotion right now than they were previously. Flag on the play. This is going to be offsides, I believe, on Turner's Indians. Falls.
5-yard penalty. Second down.
They'll bring up second and about 13 from the 37. Tough way for Seth Gowanter's career to end, if in fact it is a broken ankle. But let's see if his teammates can find a way to stay in this game. And right now they're doing a pretty good job in the first couple of plays here on Turner's Falls.
They're going to be hitting very hard for the rest of the year.
High formation. Tion Brown rolling out on second down. Fires it downfield. Looking for Craver. Incomplete. Nice defensive play. Well done.
Matt Hildreth,
nice job on defense.
Matt Hildreth on the cover for the Hawks.
And that'll bring up third down and 13.
It was in his hands. Hildreth just knocked it right out the second it touched him. Good timing to knock it in the flies also.
Matt Hildreth, the sophomore, will be a big part of this program for the next couple of years. Trips to the near side for Tion, who's going to try and throw it again. This time on third down, that one's way over the head of the intended receiver. Incomplete. And that'll bring up fourth and 13. So a punting situation for the first time.
This is good for Frontier. They can get the ball back, going down and tie it up.
About 5:21 to go in the second quarter.
Brown drops back the punt from the Indians.
Tion will boot it away, and back deep is Landry for the Frontier Redhawks. High snap, and Tion, kind of a line drive kick. It's going to bounce and come down at about the 38-yard line, which is where Frontier will take over.
38-yard line where the two Hawks take over first and 10.
Well, this is a real opportunity for the Frontier Redhawks. After forcing them to their first three and out plus the penalty.
Yep, they can go down, tie it up here. Big momentum changer. And they'll be looking to do it after the loss of Gowanter.
They've got to find a way to win the battle in the trenches on that line, because in the first quarter and a half, Turner's Falls has owned that line.
And that line's gonna be trying harder now also after the loss of Gowanter, trying to protect Landry too.
Inside draw goes to Landry.
Landry on a carry.
And that's a gain of about 4 yards. I'll bring up second and six. Yeah, Landry has not been a factor in this game so far, and it's pretty unusual. I think you're going to see him touch the ball quite a bit now. Freeman, inside draw to Landry. Jumps over a defender. First down yardage at the midfield.
Wow, he would have been stopped short of the first. He dove for the ankles, and he didn't want his ankle to get broken either, so he just hurdled him.
It's good for an 8-yard gain, so here come the Redhawks. And right now, Landry's coming off, and I think you're right, he lost a shoe on that jump, so he has to reset the shoe. And they're going to send Dalton DeForest in there as they try and figure out what happened to Landry's shoe.
By the Redhawks.
And Gordo is not going to wait. He's going to take a timeout. We're going to keep it here. 4:24 to go in the second quarter. So I don't know about you, Emilio, but I'm seeing a pronounced difference in the step of the Frontier Redhawks since the Gwanter injury. They seem to be in a different mindset mentally and emotionally than they were before.
Yep, they're very fired up after that. The first play, they were trying to, they were going out all out for Craver, trying to nail him every time, but they missed three
again,
times.
Again, at halftime,
and now on offense,
50-50 tickets
they're just running up the middle, and it's working better than it has this whole game.
And again, the injury to Gwanter is a suspected broken ankle. We don't have a definite diagnosis on that. That's what we were told. And I would doubt he'll be playing football again this year if that is, in fact, the diagnosis. So Landry and Worthley and Freeman. The three-headed monster is now a two-headed monster, and they're both in the backfield right now. Inside handoff. A little power football move, and it doesn't go very far. Does Worthley. He might have gotten a half a yard, maybe. We'll call it no gain. Second and 10.
Second and 10.
4 minutes to go in the first half.
Critical drive for the
Freeman rolling out. Pass over the middle, complete to, I believe, Joe Morawski.
Almost batted down with a long scrimmage there, too. All the hands are up, and it just went between about two of them.
Third and three for the Redhawks.
That's good for seven. Third and three from the 42 of Turner's Falls.
Miles Freeman is making these throws on point this game. Except for the deep ball.
Inside draw. Goes to Landry.
Aaron Landry
up the gut.
Perry.
Close to first down yards. I think he's got it.
That was critical.
Brown, Jack Darling on the stop for the Indians. Carry good for a Hawk first down.
They haven't tried to bounce Landry outside in this game, which is surprising to me because he's got such great speed.
37-yard line.
And we've seen him in the open field. Once he hits that hole, he's gone. But the inside holes haven't opened up a lot yet.
First and 10. Miles fires it down the right sideline. Complete! What a pass to Landry.
Way to turn around and locate that ball. That ball was behind him. He turned around, caught it right behind the defender.
That's going to spot the ball at the 11-yard line of Turner's Falls. That was good for 26.
That's going to make them excited, but they don't want to get too excited and get risky and have a turnover.
Inside draw. Goes again to Landry. See what they got. He's got about four on that one.
Gain of five, second and five.
And that was Landry again.
That was stuffed in the backfield. Another loss in the trenches by Frontier.
Third and seven for Frontier. Timeout called by the Redhawks.
Turner's is now dominating at the score line.
Well, they've been dominating at the line most of this game. But that time, that was a big stuff. I mean, Landry's starting to feel a little bit. He's starting to get some offensive mojo. And they're using him primarily as a fullback. But that time, he got a little bit of daylight to the outside. Although, in the previous play, he just got stuffed. So, ball spotted at the 8-yard line, third and seven. 2:08 to go.
This
is a big, big series for Frontier. They'd love to be able to go in here, tie it up, and come back out. It's the brand new ball game if they can tie it up and get the 2-point conversion.
Right back in.
Right back in it is right.
Around 10 minutes
ago, looked like they were gonna get dominated the whole game. Now here they are, back possibly tying it up.
Third and seven from the 8. Freeman under center in motion. Goes Landry. He gets the pitch. They sweep him right. Landry cuts back to the inside. He's brought down shy of the first down, I believe.
Wardley was close
Kyle
there on
Bergman
the pitch.
On stop.
Stopped just
short of the first down. It'll be fourth down. Fourth and about four for Frontier.
Yep, fourth and four from just outside the 5-yard line. This is huge. Pitch goes again to Landry. Cuts around the end and is brought down short of the first down by a great tackle. Nicely done by the Turner's Falls defender. I didn't get the number on that. But he got a hold of Landry and brought him down. And that's going to be a turnover on downs.
Landry's hurt on the field.
Oh, no. We've already lost Gawanter, and now Landry is down.
This is not looking good for the Red Hawks.
He's getting up slowly.
Nice hand for number 28, Aaron Landry.
And he's coming off. He did manage to get, I believe, 1 yard on that run, but not enough for the first down.
Last stop for the Indians. Turner's Falls takes over on downs first and 10.
Now, Turner's Falls could take a 2-possession lead again.
She lost three on that, so it's first and 10 at the 8-yard line. And Doyle over left tackle.
Sam Herbert on the stop for the Hawks.
That was good for eight.
2nd and 2. Doyle on a carry, 73.
Cade Gawanter
on a
stop.
Stuff
that.
He did. Let's see. Did he get the first down, though?
First down,
it's
Indians.
Definitely a first down for Turner's. Ball spotted at the 19. Teon's going to throw it. On first down, deep, incomplete.
For number 15, Nick Proto,
just a
incomplete.
Bit underthrown. Could have been a second really big play and brought them past midfield. Just a bit underthrown, and you know, as I said earlier, football's a game of inches, and even with throws.
Absolutely. Second and 10 now upcoming from the 19 of Turner's Falls. 39.5 seconds to go in the half. And inside handoff.
Doyle on a carry.
Goes to Doyle again.
Matt Carlson on a stop for Frontier.
And he gets about a yard, maybe two. Give him one. Third and nine.
Third and nine
looks
for
like
the Indians.
They might let the clock run out here.
Yeah, probably a good idea. They're deep at their own end. Don't want to fumble. Well, I don't know what one more play looks like.
Gordon isn't calling a timeout, though.
Inside draw again goes to Doyle.
Doyle on the carry.
And he loses a yard. And that will end the first half
Carlson
of football.
That's the end of the first half.
We have played one half of football from Frontier Regional School. At the end of one half, Turner's Falls 14. Frontier 6. Second half action upcoming. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television.
noise here for the Red Hawk cheerleaders. Good evening, Frontier fans. It's now time for Halftime Entertainment, presenting the Red Hot Sound of the Frontier Regional School. It's the 2016 Frontier Marching Band. The band is under the direction of Mr. Matt Sherrill. Seniors are Joe Morosky, Billy Prunier, and Melissa Shaw. Tonight they're going to open the show with one of the most famous tunes of the 70s horn rock band Chicago. Every band student, young or old, should know and love this song. Here's the 1970s classic, 25 or 6 to 4. Song jumps at several decades from the 70s to the present, made famous by the pop singer Larry King. Here's a fun and swinging number, X's and O's. Tonight is another great tune from the 2010s. This song is by the pop funk band Fall Out Boy and features a melody from the Munsters TV show. Here's the song Uma Thurman.
Yeah, I can hear.
And the band's final tune tonight jumps back to the funkiest decade of all, the 70s, made famous by the Motown group, the Commodores. Here's a group that everybody can get down and sing along to. Here's Brick House. Great hand for the Frontier Regional Band and the direction of Matt Sherrill. Great job, Ben.
Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna, Kevin Murphy, Zach Pelk, and Alec Echo back here at Frontier Regional School. Second half action upcoming. Let's recap scoring in the first half, Emilio. In the first quarter, Turner's Falls got on the board with a Quinn Doyle one-yard run. A Ricky Craver pass from Tion Brown made it 8-0. In the next series, Turner's came back again and scored. Ricky Craver, a 13-yard pass from Tion Brown. The PAT pass fell incomplete to make it 14-0. And then Seth Gowaner, with a two-yard run in the second quarter, made the score 14-6. Gowaner was injured, a suspected broken ankle on the PAT run. And 14-6 is where we stand. But interesting, just taking a look at the first half numbers, you know, this Frontier Redhawk team has been a high-powered offense, especially in terms of the run all season. They've had a number of games well over 300 yards. In that first half, only 65 yards in ground offense, 52 yards through the air. But that's unheard of. I mean, Wordley has 20 yards. Gowanter had 13 before he left the game. And Aaron Landry, only 32 yards in that first half. Pretty amazing.
Yeah, definitely not one of their best games.
But I can give credit to Turner's Falls. I mean, they've won the battle in the trenches. They've won the battle on the line. They've controlled the running game in a way no other team has been able to with Frontier this year. On the Turner's Falls side of the ball, they amassed 120 yards first half rushing offense. Quinn Doyle, 16 carries, 66 yards. Jack Darling, 6 carries, 36. And Ricky Craver ran the ball once for 19 yards. Tion Brown, 1 of 6 passing for 13 yards, that being the 13-yard touchdown pass to Craver. And Miles Freeman for Frontier, 4 for 6 passing for 52 yards. Two of those passes went to Aaron Landry. One went to Cole Price. And one went to Joe Morosky. So that's where we stand stat-wise in the first half. Both teams committing two penalties. Frontier losing 18 yards. Turner's Falls losing 15. Both teams punted. And the Turner's Falls Indians now coming back onto the field after talking things over at the half. Frontier's already on the field. And you saw the look in the eyes of the Frontier Hawks and the team out of Emilio. They mean business. And Frontier's going to get the ball to start this.
Kicking off for the Indians. Number 11, Tion Brown. Deep for the Redhawks is number 10, Miles Freeman
is deep. For the Frontier Redhawks, Tion Brown to kick it off for Turner's Falls. This is a big, big offensive series for the Frontier Redhawks. They need to score here, I think.
They could have called a timeout before half and maybe had a play or so, but
Brown.
That's not what they decided.
Low end over end kick. Taking it about the 31-yard line and run back up. Worthley brings it back up to about the 44, so that's a pretty good, decent field position for the Frontier Redhawks.
From the Frontier.
Nice cut, too.
That ball spotted at the 42 of Frontier. So let's see what Miles Freeman digs out of his bag of tricks here to start this first half for the Redhawks, down 14-6. Once again, without Seth Gwanter, out with a suspected broken ankle. Miles rolls out, keeps the ball, tucks it and runs. First down yardage and more. Miles Freeman up the gut, inside Turner's Falls territory.
What a play by Freeman, shaking off the tackles behind the line of scrimmage and scrambling for over 10 yards.
That is good for 13 yards on the scramble by Miles Freeman. First and 10, Frontier.
And that always makes the quarterback happy because he's supposed to be throwing the ball, but when he can take it on the ground, that's all.
Inside give to Aaron Landry.
Landry
brought down at about the 40-yard line, so here comes Landry and the Redhawks. Gain of 5.
Owen Ortiz on the stop for the Indians. Gain of 5, second and 5.
Second and 5 at the 40. This is starting to look like the Redhawk team of old.
Landry got hurt at the end of the first half, but he looks better than the first half by far so far.
Freeman inside give to Worthley. Worthley gets a couple of yards inside the 40 to about 38.
Ricky Smith on the stop for the Indians. Third and 4 for the Redhawks.
Call it 3rd and 3 from the 38-yard line. Freeman. Handoff to Landry, who gets thrown to the ground. He got drilled to the ground, taken down by the shirt.
Jack Darling on the stop.
I think he's close to the first down. I don't think he's got it, though.
He had a lot of room, but that defender decided to, like, curl him around, kept him short of the first.
No, I mean, they've got such speed on the ends, and Darling is just so quick. So that was good pursuit. 4th and 1, I think we're gonna go for it here, I would think. From the 36. Full house backfield behind Miles. He's gonna roll out and throw. Quick pass over the middle, incomplete to Morosky. Bangs himself in the helmet, and they're gonna turn it over. I think that, you know, that's one of those situations where
take over 1st and 10.
Not happy.
You're really going to run the ball there, I think. 4th and 1 yard.
Yep. It's, Freeman can do it through the air. He's done it before, but you can't always rely on it. And, you know, this season, the run has been working much better for them on 1st, 2nd, and 3rd down, and 4th down, too.
1st and 10 for Turners. Tion to Quinn Doyle. Doyle over left tackle, gets up to about the 39, that's going to be a gain of about 3.
Steve Worley on a stop. Gain of about 3 yards. It'll be 2nd and 7.
2nd and 7 from the 39 of Turner's Falls. Again, they would love to take as much time off this clock as possible. Tion. Inside handoff. Actually, it's a counter play the other way. And that's Doyle again.
Doyle on a carry.
They've been having good blocks all game. And again, the line opens up a hole. He just runs right through it. Good gain.
3rd and 2.
7 or 8 yards.
Yep. 3rd and 1 from the 45. For the Turner's Falls Indians. They've been blowing open holes all night for Doyle and for Darling. Pitch goes to Jack Darling. And he gets stopped. I don't know if he got it. He was on his way to a first down. Let's see where they spot it. That was Steve Worley, and he did get the first down.
$244, the Frontier Clearance. Thank you for your generous support. Winning number 635793. 635793.
So first down for the Indians, 7:33 to go in the third quarter. Full house backfield again behind Teon Brown. Frontier defense jumped, but there's no flag down. And a swarm of Red Hawk defenders brings down Quaden Doyle for a rare loss.
Good thing they weren't offsides there because they stuffed him in the backfield. They'll be proud of that one.
Magic Matt Carlson with the stop. A loss of two brings up second and 12 from the 45 of Turner's Falls. I formation behind Teon. One receiver goes in motion. Pitch goes to Doyle. Doyle runs around left end, trying to get loose. He got up to about the 48 or 9 yard line. Hildreth on the stop, and here comes the train. Going to pick up a three. Ball spotted at the 48. It's going to be third and 9 from the 48.
An injury timeout.
We have an injured player down. Not sure who it is. On the far side of the field, tough to see from here.
Somebody on Turner's Falls. Blue helmet out there, takes it off. He can take his helmet off.
Ball spotted just outside the 48-yard line. Again, the injured player, we don't have a number. It has not been a good night for injuries. Of course, this is a couple of teams that play very physical styles of football. Again, the winner of this game, well, if Frontier wins this game, they share a piece of the Intercounty League North crown. Turner's Falls already has clinched a piece of it. And the injured player is up, and that's good to see. So we're going to resume football here. So be about a third and 9. It was Quinn Doyle that got hurt. So again, a Turner's Falls captain goes down to injury. How long he'll be out, though, is anybody's guess.
Third and 7. From the Indian 48-yard line.
So Teon Brown comes in without Quinn Doyle now, who's on the sidelines after the injury.
The Red Hawks are excited about that.
Third down, slip backfield, trips to the right. Teon's going to throw. Ooh, and he gets drilled. Gets the pass off to Craver, complete. Craver's got first
pass
down yardage.
Five,
but Deion took a
Craver.
Hit, but Craver was able to pick that.
Deion's coming off. He's going to the sidelines.
He got popped by a backside bandit. I'm not sure who got him, but he really got smacked. Ball spotted at the 41 of Frontier. That's
I thought that was Borski.
Gain for an 11-yard gain for Craver. He has caught two balls for 24 yards tonight. Brown under center again. In motion goes Craver. Pitch goes to Darling. Jack gets around the end. What great speed he has. So explosive around the end.
That's one great quality any coach would love to have in their running back. Turner's Falls has it here.
Just so quick.
Tipped up at the Red Hawk 34-yard line. Second and three
from the 34 of Frontier. And inside draw goes to Darling again. Of course, without Doyle in there, Darling's going to get the majority of the touches. He may be close to first down yardage. See where they spot it.
Third and a short yard for the Indians.
Ball's at the 32.
John Torres on the carry.
Good Torres, good for a first down. So the Indians pick up the first.
First and 10 from the Redhawks, 30-yard line.
The Redhawks are not looking good on these short yard situations on defense or offense so far.
Fresh set of downs from the 30-yard line, 4:34 to go, third quarter. Turner's Falls Frontier leads Frontier 14-6, and they're knocking on the door of another score. Pitch goes to Jack Darling, left side.
Jack Darling on the
Darling
carry.
Spins through, gets loose, and Darling is going to go to the end zone. What a play by Jack Darling. Great individual effort, broke two tackles, tore down the left sideline, 6 points.
All of them, everybody was grabbing at him there. They had his jersey. He just ripped out of everybody, and his speed showed there, breaking it for about a 30-yard touchdown.
30-yard touchdown run for smiling Jack Darling and the Turner's Falls Indians. Lead 20-6 with a two-point conversion upcoming. I mean, we thought he was down for a loss, and he just blasted down the sideline.
Yep.
Indians will attempt a two-point conversion.
If you have speed, breaking tackles is immensely good for you because once you break those tackles, you have the speed to burst around that edge.
Jack's been on
once you have that edge, you have room,
tear
too.
Is the now flag is, flags flying everywhere as the Frontier Wordly. Player jumped off. I think that was Wordly, you're right. So they're going to push him half the distance to the goal.
Offside on the Redhawks, half the distance to the goal.
To set him up at the two. If they can punch this here, it makes a 22-6 lead. Darling, off left
Darling
tackle,
in
through,
for the
and in.
For
so Jack Darling finishes what he starts. We'll come back up the field
the Redhawks,
with the score. Turner's Falls 22, Frontier 6. Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna, back out here at Frontier Regional Score. Executive producer is Kevin Murphy. Camera people is Zach Pelk and Alec Eckel. And the
Indians back for the Redhawks is number 10.
Frontier Redhawks are in trouble right now. They're trailing 22-6, 4:18 to go in the third quarter. And the Turner's Falls Indians are rolling. They've lost Quinn Doyle to injury. Jack Darling picked right up where Quinn left off and runs in for a 30-yard touchdown run. Finished it off with a two-point conversion run. And the Indians open up a 22-6 lead. Tion Brown to boot it away for Turner's. End over end kick taken at about the 21-yard line by Landry, who's brought down at about the 35. Good for a 14-yard return, and that's where Frontier will take it over.
He could have had a fair amount more yards there, but he muffed it. Didn't pick it up on the first try, then tried again, didn't pick it up again. Finally grabbed a hold of it, but by then, Turner's Falls was squirming.
Ball spotted at the 33-yard line. Again, the Frontier Redhawks without Seth Gowanter down to a broken ankle in the first half. But they still got Wordley, and they still got Landry and Miles Freeman. Inside crossbuck handoff goes to Landry. First down yardage and more, maybe.
Landry on the carry.
You know, that little crossbuck handoff, Wordley to Landry or vice versa, it seems to be working well for Frontier.
That pile pushing definitely passed, made him pass the first down. It would have been a second and short. In any short yard situation, the Redhawks have not been good at it yet. Should not have been good.
Well, once again, I go back to what I said before. It's been Turner's Falls. It's dominated the line plates. That's what's been the difference.
Definitely. The trenches are, this game is the trenches. And Turner's Falls is winning.
Inside give to Wordley, good for four.
Tanner Castine on a stop.
And back to the 48-yard line.
Gain of four.
Frontier's got
six.
Some work to do here,
second
but it's doable. I mean, there's definitely time to come back. They just got to get that juggernaut offensive line and the running game going. Inside give again to Wordley. It's the right corner, first down yards, I believe. He gets swarmed. And did he get it? I think he did.
Good play by Wardley there. Diving for the first down.
This looks like a gimme, but they may have to measure it.
First down, Frontier.
No, it is a first down.
First
and 10. It looked like he made
it. Indian territory. At the Turner's 46-yard line.
Hawks at the 46. Frame under center. Inside give again. This time to Wardley. A lot of touches tonight. And gets down to about the 40-yard line. Good for six.
Second and four
from the 40. 2:27 to go in the third. Frontier on the move. Inside give goes to Landry. Up the middle. Still on his feet. Landry breaks it. Down the left sideline. Aaron Landry in for two. Touchdown. 22-12.
What a way to spin away from both of those tackles. Two people had him, slipped out of the jerseys, did the spin, he's gone. That's what Landry's been doing all season and proving himself once again.
That is what the doctor ordered. Aaron Landry broke a couple of tackles, got free, and those great jets down the left sideline and in for the score.
What a play.
So the Redhawks, there is life in Redhawk Nation.
Now more than ever, and that was a good time to get it.
Big two-point conversion here. Freeman. Fumble. Picks it up. Did he get in? Still fumbled. And Turner's recovered. So the fumble fails the two-point conversion. We'll bring it back up the field. Turner's Falls Indians still lead 22-12. Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. The Red Hawks get on the scoreboard again, courtesy of an Aaron Landry 40-yard touchdown run. Fumble snap on the two-point conversion. Makes the score 22-12.
Tried to pick it up, fumbled it again. Or he didn't even fully pick it up. But not good.
Light to boot it away for the Redhawks. Got to make a stop here. Corbin nails it all the way down to the 15. Brought back up the left sideline, still going. And up to about the 45-yard line. Good field position for Turner's Falls.
Yeah, it looked like they had him around the 30-yard line. Broke out for another 10 or 15 yards.
From the Turner's 42-yard line.
So 2 minutes to go in the third quarter, and Turner's Falls at their own 42 to start this next drive. Three receivers now in motion. Goes Darling, and the handoff goes inside to Jack Darling. And he picks up about 4 yards on that one.
Gain of four, second and six.
So again, we have not seen Quinn Doyle since the injury.
He's been on the sidelines, which has not been good for them since he was dominating before he went out.
Well, he's a game changer for sure. But Jack Darling has done a pretty good job in his stead.
Yep. One of the biggest ways to prove your worth on the team is by coming in for a backup and playing just like him.
The pitch goes to Darling. Fumble! Was it a fumble? I'm going to say he was down. Jack Darling just ran over a Frontier player and lost the ball, but his knee had hit the ground. So this is not going to be a fumble. But there is a Frontier player who got laid out. It's Cade Gawanter. And also slow to get up on that one was John Torres.
Indian first down, first and 10.
That was
a
devastating hit by the running back. Laying out Cade.
Well, that kid is, you know, Jack Darling is not a huge kid, but he's fast, but he's real tough. Plays much bigger, much more physical than his size would indicate.
Definitely has the momentum to lay the hits.
First and 10, Turner's from the Frontier 44-yard line. Double wing offense. It goes an inside handoff to Torres.
By a host of Red Hawks.
And he gets a couple of yards up to about the 42. Actually, about that. Let's give him one.
Coming up, give him two. Last play of the quarter.
Second and eight from the 40. Just outside the 42-yard line, and they're not going to get a playoff here. That's going to be the end of the third quarter.
Just
going to let it run out. So we have played three. From South Deerfield will change ends. The end of three, the Turners Falls Indians 22. Frontier Red Hawks 12. This is high school football. Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Emilio Didonna back here at Frontier Regional School. Kevin Murphy is our executive producer. Zach Pelk and Alec Eckel run the cameras tonight. Is second and eight from the 42 for Turners. And there's Darling again up the right sideline. So bloody fast.
That was a great hole. And with Darling's speed, he can hit that easily and he can just keep going. That's Darling.
He gets inside the 20 to about the 19.
With breakouts like that, they've been doing that all game. If they keep doing it, that's going to be a pretty,
11-yard line.
Pretty easy win for Turner's Falls.
The 11?
If Frontier can't stop that.
Darling on a carry.
Jack Darling again gets down to about the 11.
Worthy on a stop. Gain of a couple, second and eight.
And this is going the other way. Craver up the middle, flag down. This is probably going to be a hold.
Ricky Craver on a carry.
Could have been a touchdown there. Got called back. Never good for an offense.
Holding on Turners. A 10-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Ball is spotted at about the 16-yard line. Double wing offense again. In motion goes Darling. Darling gets the pitch up the right side, bounces
Darling
off, gets swarmed in up over and brought down.
Down from behind by 79.
Inside the 15 to the 14.
Third and nine for Turners. The Frontier 10-yard line.
Ball spot at the 11. High formation behind Tion. Brown is going to roll out. Fires to the end zone. Intercepted!
What a pick!
Miles Freeman with one hand picked it off. What a play by Miles Freeman.
That was an incredible interception.
With one hand, Miles Freeman stepped in front of the receiver and pulled it in.
He was wide open in the end zone, but one hand, Miles Freeman could just stick it out. And that's an interception.
So the Frontier Redhawks, that is an amazing play. I'm sure we'll see that one on replay.
That is the catch of the game.
First and 10 from the 19. So that is a big time play by a big time player. Fumble, ball loose. I think Frontier recovered it, but they lost maybe a yard.
Frontier needs to drive down quickly, get into that end zone because they're down two possessions.
Second and 11.
Freeman under center, rolling out right, firing it downfield, going for it all, and he is intercepted.
Freeman's pass is intercepted by
Nick
Croteau, and they had double coverage on Price, and Croteau just turned around and picked it off.
Not a good read by Miles Freeman. He was well covered. There was a man open in the flats, but that wasn't something he could see.
I don't think Price ever saw the ball. He was trying to turn around and get a look at it, but by the time he turned around and got a look at it, Croteau sort of had out-jumped him and took it away. So that's
definitely not a good decision.
Not a good. Well, you know, it was an idea. It was, they were trying to catch him in the turn his flat foot, and it didn't work, obviously.
Definitely not.
Split backs behind Teyon Brown again. And Darling, who's been the workhorse of the second half with a runoff right tackle. And he picks up a couple of yards to about the 42.
Freeman on a stop. Gain
second
of
and
three,
seven, 42.
Seven.
As the clock is in motion, time is running out for the Redhawks. 8 minutes to go in the game. Trailing 22-12, Turner's with the ball. And I would think, Emilio, that a touchdown here would pretty much seal the Redhawks' fate.
Yep. The Redhawks need some kind of turnover like Miles Freeman got. But one thing they do need is to play, do something on offense.
Inside give to Craver. He slipped, lost his footing. Otherwise, he had a little gain headed up.
It's a bit messy after snowing all day.
Yeah. I was wondering what kind of condition that the field would be in.
That was surprisingly the first slip of the game by a ball carrier.
Third and five from the 40 as the clock continues to roll. Again, Quinn Doyle out of the game with an injury, which occurred in the third quarter. Now Darling gets the handoff around in, tries the counter run, gets brought down at great speed. He's going to be close to first down yards, but I don't think he got it.
Cade Duwanter on a stop.
Yeah, Cade's slow to get up.
Fourth and about a yard
bring
for
up
the
fourth
Indians.
And one, so we're going to give 4 yards to Darling on that run. Fourth and one. From the 36.
They need to stop him here if they have a chance at anything.
Well, I agree. They definitely need to make a stop here if they can. High formation again behind Teyon. And it's going to go to Darling. Up the gut. He's got the first down and more.
First down and not good for the Redhawks.
Well, this one, the headline tomorrow, I'm pretty sure is going to read, this one's one in the trenches, because the line play for Turner's has been absolutely outstanding. You just can't argue with that.
Definitely.
You knew this was going to be a battle of two great defenses, two great lines, and Turner's has gotten the better of it.
Yep, the game's
first 10
pretty much over, but let's see if
30-yard line.
Frontier can have a miracle up their sleeves.
Jack Darling again off right tackle.
Jack Darling on the carry.
He's just so quick, so elusive.
Freeman on a stop.
He get close to first down yardage, but I'm not sure if he got it. I don't think he did. And he got about 8 yards. Down to the 22 of Frontier.
Second and two.
Clock in motion. 5:30 to go in the game. Frontier's playoff hopes are starting to ebb away. Double wing formation behind Teyon. Darling in motion. Inside draw goes to the fullback.
John Torres on the carry.
Torres. And he pulls ahead, and they've got a first down. They'll move the chains again. Nothing fancy about that, just straight ahead bull rushing. That gets him to about the 16-yard line.
On the Frontier 19-yard line.
Excuse me, the 19-yard line. So that's good for three for Torres. Brown again. This time it goes to Jack.
Darling
left side.
Miles Freeman on the stop.
But he's so explosive out of that backfield, Emilio. Really, just a, he's had a great game.
He's got the speed, and he can hit the hole as well. He
second
has great vision as a ball carrier to find those holes and burst through.
Second and five from the 14 of Frontier. As much like the first drive of the game, Turner's is kind of moving the ball at will here. Motion again goes Darling, gets the pitch, hits the line. This time he gets wrapped up by Cade Gawantra and company and pulled down. And I don't think he got anywhere on that one. He might have lost a yard.
That was good for the Redhawks. Turner's Falls didn't lose anything there either.
Yeah, he did get a yard. Third and four from the 13. Inside of 4 minutes. Again, eye formation behind Jack Darling. Tion Brown, rather. Jack Darling is in the eye. He's going to get it off left tackle.
Darling on a carry.
Pushes ahead. I don't think he's got first down yards. He might. Let's see where they spot it.
This will be a close one.
Yep.
Guess
it wasn't as close as we thought. First and goal.
That is a big play for Turner's.
May as well call it first and game, because if they punch it in here, this is pretty much over. And they're going to end the season undefeated, going as the number one seed most likely in the upcoming tournament. And for the Frontier Redhawks, as amazing as the year has been, it's not looking like they're going to see postseason action, which is unfortunate and surprising.
Even if they lose this one, only two losses. Still,
yeah.
Not playoffs.
Darling again is close to the goal line.
Carry. Corbin Boyd on the stop.
Good speed outside. Good fair blocks.
Second and goal.
Second and goal from it looks like the one.
Inside the 1 yard line.
Well, the MVP of this second half has been Jack Darling for sure, especially with the injury to Quinn Doyle. He's had to step up.
Oh, by far.
And he has had a fantastic second frame. Timeout on the field.
By the Indians.
We're going to keep it here with 2:16 to go. Should mention one more time, this is senior night. And we're saying goodbye to a number of Frontier seniors. Miles Freeman is one of the captains. Also Alper and Yidlis. I hope I'm pronouncing that name right. Dalton DeForest. Joe Morawski, also a captain. Cade Gawantra and Seth Gawantra, both captains. J.B. Delaney. Luke Parsons and Ryan Olmstead. We should also mention the parents, Craig and Nicole Freeman, a friend of mine from years back. Hamdi and Harva Yidlis, Chip and Kelly DeForest, Mike and Cindy Morawski, Brett and Kristen Gawanter, Brian and Kristen Delaney, Jeff and Pam Parsons and Heidi Olmstead, and Jeff and Jody Olmstead. Congratulations, folks. Great kids. Part of a great program, which unfortunately is going to come up on the losing end of this one, looks like, as there is just too much Turner's Falls Indians offense and defense for the Hawks on this day. Second and goal from the one. I'm guessing number 13 is probably going to get the ball here. What do you think?
Yep. Darling, right up the middle or outside. They've been doing all drive, and it's probably what they're going to do.
Yep.
Jack Darling.
Darling, did he get in? He's in. Touchdown, Jack Darling.
Touchdown, Indians.
And that makes it 28-12.
And that pretty much sealed the deal.
I would think. How fitting, the way Jack Darling has played in this second half, that he would get what could be the final score in this game. 2-point conversion upcoming.
Players are going to be hyping him up this week in practice after coming in for Doyle and definitely replacing him.
Well, and we don't know the status of Doyle's injury. We know Gawantra has gone out with an ankle injury. We don't know about Doyle.
But who knows? Maybe even if Doyle could come back, they'll still start Darling after today.
Darling.
Darling.
Darling. did not get in on the conversion run, so Frontier stops the conversion run. Come back up the field with the score. Turner's Falls 28 and Frontier 12. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. 2:11 left in this one. It's pretty much academic after that score by Jack Darling, a one-yard touchdown run. He was stopped on the two-point conversion, but that keeps the score 28-12.
The Red Hawks are going to need the miracle of the season here in a two-possession game. That would send it to overtime if they got both two-point conversions, which has been messing them up all game.
Miles Freeman back.
I'm not sure that, I mean, it's just been, this has been a dominant performance by a very good football team. Turner's Falls Indians are for real. That goose egg in the lost column is well-deserved. Tion kicks it deep, down to about the 22-yard line or so. Worthy runs it back up to about the 40, just inside the 40, which is where they will start.
He has not been taking the kickoff well today, bobbling. I think that was the third one of the day that he muffed. But he does have great speed to put it back.
He does. I mean, it's been a tough night for all the Frontier backs.
They've been
popped around. And the funny thing is, you know, this is such a physical team, Frontier. It's surprising to see them get pushed around like this.
Oh, yeah.
Freeman is going to roll right. He's got the corner. Ooh, what a hit by Craver.
Picks him up and slams him on the ground after nailing him.
Oh, Craver just drilled Freeman.
Craver's been having a great game all around.
Ball is spotted at midfield.
1:40 on the clock.
It's good for a 7-yard gain. 2nd and 3 at the 50. Turner's Falls sidelines feeling pumped up. You can hear it. Freeman, pass over the middle, complete to Cole Price.
Pass complete to Cole Price. Completion good for a Red Hawk first down.
That'll spot the ball at about the 40. Three.
They wish they could have been driving like this all game. 20 seconds in the first down. It's probably the fastest of the game.
Minute to go in the contest. Miles gonna throw again. Pass intended for
30.
Corbin Blight is incomplete.
2nd and 10.
That'll stop the clock with 1:03. 2nd and 10 from the 43 of Turner's. Freeman. Handoff inside to Landry. Landry gets brought down at about the line of scrimmage as Tion Brown just came up and stuck him.
Broke two there.
Timeout, Red Hawks.
You can't break all of them.
He got one. They'll bring up 3rd and 9 from the 43.
A lot of work for a one-yard gain there.
Well, and ordinarily, that'd be a run that Landry might take to the house. He's certainly broken enough of those this year. But Tion Brown just came up and stopped him. I mean, a lot's going to be said about the offensive performance of the Turner's Falls Indians. But the MVP of this game has been that line. I got to keep saying it.
Yep.
You know, we knew that this was going to be not only a battle of two great offenses, but two great defenses. And I think Turner's Falls absolutely manhandled the front four.
Yes, the Red Hawks have been having not very good play in the trenches.
Well, I think that they played well. I just think that Turner's just played better. I don't think you can fault Frontier's performance. I mean, in a situation like this, you're just facing a team that's better and came in with a better game plan. They came in down here, they punched Frontier in the mouth. Not an easy thing to do. No other team's really done it this year except for Athol, and there were a lot of reasons why that Athol game ended up in a loss for Frontier, but.
This is a well-deserved win for Turner's Falls.
And my colleagues at the recorder, Jay Botinski and Mark Durant, called it. I took Frontier, so did Gary Sanderson. And I still would have made that pick before this one, knowing what I knew about the Red Hawks, but all hats off to the Turner's Falls Indians. They have played well. Oh, my God.
Landry on a carry.
Landry just got absolutely buried. Who was that?
Tanner Castine.
It's Castine, number 56. Ay,
he
caramba.
He is down.
And he, I'm not surprised he's down. He got absolutely whacked.
What a hit.
And it wasn't a dirty hit. That was all clean.
There have been a lot of big hits this game.
Well, we saw Landry get shaken up earlier, not long after the Gwanter injury. He came off the field and he was fine. But that one was pretty, we could feel the contact up here.
What do you guys got next week?
The whole field's probably shaking right now.
Oh, you don't know who you guys got.
So we've had some injuries in this game to key personnel. Seth Gwanter, Quinn Doyle for Turner's Falls, and now Landry get drilled. Hopefully he's all right. He has not gotten up yet, though.
Somebody told us that one of the coaches
said we had to. Chris Collins and Emilio Didonna here at Frontier Regional School, and this game, which had 37 seconds left to go, has been terminated. The injury was not to Aaron Landry, it was to Stephen Wordley, who was hit very cleanly by Tyler Castine as he was coming up the middle. And the referees have decided to end this game 37 seconds early. So let's recap the scoring, as we certainly hope Steve Wordley is okay. But scoring open in the first quarter with Quinn Doyle with a 1-yard touchdown run. Craver got the pass from Tion Brown to make it 8-0. Turner's Falls scored again in the next series. Craver with a 13-yard pass from Tion Brown. Pass filling complete to make it 14-0. Seth Gwanter got Frontier on the board in the second quarter with a 2-yard run. Gwanter was stopped on the PAT run and in the process was injured, a severe ankle injury apparently. In the third quarter, Turner's Falls extended the lead with Jack Darling with a 30-yard touchdown run. Darling hit the run point after to make it 22-6. Aaron Landry got on the board for Turner's, or for Frontier rather, with a 40-yard run. Fumbled snap made it 22-12, and Darling with a 1-yard run created the final 28-12. And the game again ending prematurely on the injury to Stephen Wordley. Emilio Didonna, final thoughts.
Well, it was a well-fought game, but in the end, Turner's Falls won really through the trenches and through Jack Darling.
I would agree. Jack Darling, I think, would be the player of the game in my estimation, just based on his performance in the second half when Quinn Doyle went down to the injury. And, of course, the story right now, the larger story, is what's happening on the field right now as Steve Wordley is being tended to after that wicked hit by Tyler Castine. But the Frontier Redhawks suffer their second loss of the game, of the season rather. The Turner's Falls Indians go to 8-0 on the year, and they clinch the Intercounty League North Championship, and they will go to the postseason. Frontier will not, but I'm sure they'll be in action next week against an as-yet-to-be-named opponent. And certainly we hope Stephen Wordley and Seth Gwanter both recover quickly from the injury. And we don't know what the situation is with Steve. He is right now down on the 40-yard line. But this game is over. And unfortunately, on a down note, but it was a great contest and a big win for the Turner's Falls Indians. That'll do it for our coverage from Frontier Regional School on senior night. And we want to thank, of course, Emilio Didonna for once again joining me and the whole crew here. Kevin Murphy, our executive producer. We also want to thank Zach Pelk and Alec Eckel for running the cameras. My name is Chris Collins. The final score for the final time from South Deerfield. The Turner's Falls Indians beat the Frontier Redhawks by a score of 28-12. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you next time on Frontier Redhawk Football.